Hey, Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Welcome to the Christmas Room.
Sit back, relax. You are about to watch a Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg.
Welcome to the Christmas Room. I'm Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida, and I want to talk a little bit today, maybe about a camera that's kind of like under the radar. We're talking Canon R5. We're talking Sony 7.3. There's other cameras out there, and one of them is the one that I'm actually using right now. And it doesn't get a whole lot of love. Does it deserve more love, or does it actually not deserve a lot of love? Well, I started taking wedding photography pictures way back in the 80s through film, and then boom. In the year 2000, the world switched and started to switch over to digital. And the big argument then was not overheating or underheating, and it wasn't even RAW or JPEG. The big argument back then was only real photographers use film. Okay, a real photographer does not use digital. So that was the argument that started in 2000, 2001, 2002. And of course, the history went through the ages until we arrive today. And of course, we have our arguments today that we run through. Now, part of the way through that, at the beginning, I was Canon, 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 Canon. So what do you think I shot with? Canon, very good, okay. But Canon tripped on itself in 2008, 2009 area, and that opened the door, boom, for Nikon. So Peter Gregg Photography, moi, we opened the door to adding Nikon. I hadn't shot Nikon. Nikon was the other guys over the hill that I didn't pay all that much attention to. But then the Canon cameras started to not focus properly, and Canon had to get involved to try to get it all fixed up and make things work properly. And then little by little, they got back on their feet. But that opened the door for me to start shooting with Nikon. So I started shooting professionally with Nikon D3 bodies. A D3X was the next move up. And then after that, I moved to a D800E. And then I pretty much faded out into what they call new tires. No, retire. I kind of retired. But I did sell the D800E. And out of nowhere, video popped up. And I found myself doing video, like, what's up with video? Real photographers shoot film, right? Real photographers shoot JPEG, right? Wrong. The first one, film, wrong. And real photographers don't shoot video. Isn't that true? Well, guess what? Wrong. Okay, so video is now a mainstream. And I really wasn't even awake to video, to be honest with you. What got me into video is out of nowhere, I wound up with a check, cash, some money, moolah. I was looking at it, and it came from Google, and it was from my YouTube channel, which I didn't pay hardly any attention to at all. Basically, the video channel at that point was mostly to actually show people my products, like this video is being color graded with, this is a professional high-end item. This is not the right white, okay? This is called a better white balance. This is the right white, and you guys have been used to the right white. Now, the right white is actually for after the fact, meaning you record it, you put this here, you record it, you take a picture or whatever it is, and then once you're in the computer, the right white actually is where you would do your color balance by using an eyedropper. You know what an eyedropper is, right? And you go bing, and you click on that, and it gets your color pretty well in line, and then you can fine tune it from there. This works the opposite. Not that you can't put it here and click on it, because you can, all right? But the way this works is you take a camera, and then you put this in front of the camera. You do the settings correctly and all that's in the directions. So you put this right in front of the lens. And if you put it right up to the lens, see how you can see the lens? No, no, no. You've got to pull it away, you know, 3 or 4 inches. And you shoot a picture. You do a custom color balance, okay? And you aim it at your main lights, because your main light, whatever your main light source is, it could be anything. That's what's getting on the face. Ow. Okay, so that's what goes on the face, and that's what you want to color correct. So you do a custom white balance there. So I was teaching that stuff and talking about the color balance, and I was talking about flash, bouncing the flash and stuff like that. And suddenly I got a check in the mail, and it came to me, and it was from Google, and I said, oh, money, very nice. I like getting checks in the mail. So I looked at my YouTube, and I'm going like, well, I've been using it for that. How about if I start talking about things that I have 20, 30 years of experience at and start making videos? And hence, the channel just continued on from that point. So now I find myself doing a lot of video, but I love doing pictures. So one of the best cameras that I've ever used for that, of course, for the pictures, was the Nikon and the Canons. And now, when I got into video, I went with Sony. And why? I don't particularly like the Sony camera. Maybe the new ones that's coming out, the S3, okay, but the menus were cumbersome and it wasn't so wonderful. What can I tell you? So, but I bought what I needed to buy for this channel so that I would actually have a good looking picture. Having a good looking picture is important to me. Without a good looking picture, how can I come to you and say, well, I've been a photographer since the 80s, even before that, as a kid. And they're, you know, people are going to look and go like, well, you look like crap. So for me, it was important to get that good looking picture. And you know what was giving it at the time? The Sony A7 III. I call it the A73. So it's the A7 Mark III. So I bought one of those. I bought a beautiful Zeiss 50mm 1.4 lens. And I didn't build up the lens system. That's the important part of a camera these days, is the lens system. You gotta look at what lenses you're gonna buy, and you gotta look at what it's gonna cost you. So I wasn't super happy with the Sony lens system, so I didn't develop it. So lo and behold, Nikon came out with a Z6 and a Z7, and I was so happy. Can't wait to get my hands on one of those. So I got myself a Z6 in here. Boom, this was 2 years ago maybe, and it flopped flat on its face. And I'm going like, oh no, wait a minute, I have a 50mm 1.4, I have a 24mm 1.4, I have a 24-70 2.8, I have the 70-200 with the IBIS in it, they call it the VR 2.8. All these wonderful lenses just sitting there waiting. But the Z6 couldn't compare with the A7 Mark III. So you know what? After I bought it, I hung my head almost in shame and I sent it back. So I stayed for many years with the Sony A73. Then a friend of mine in January said, look, I got this beta of a new firmware coming out for the Nikon Z6. And I'm going, I went through that. I'm so disappointed. I was just like, I can't believe it. I'm in the Sony. He says, no, Peter, you got to try it. And his name was Peter. Okay. So it was a little bit ironic. His name was Peter. So he says, you got to try it. And I said, no. And he said, yes, try it. I love it. So I got, I think in February of this year, I got the Z6 loaner from B&H. And they sent it to me. And I got it in here. And the firmware that it had was firmware 2.0. So it's 2.0. So I put it on there and I go, yep, that's what I remember. This sucker can't focus. I don't know what Peter's talking about. So we were on the phone. He says, you've got to put the new firmware in there. You're not going to believe that it's a brand spanking new camera in terms of video focusing. And it's even going to help in the picture focusing. And I said, are you kidding me? And he said, go try it. So I realized, wait a minute. I have this camera and I don't even have an XQD card, which is what they take. So how am I supposed to upgrade it? So Peter told me, I'm going to send you down my reader, buy yourself a card for the camera. So I bought a card for the camera. He sent me his card reader. Thank you, Peter. And lo and behold, I updated it. And wow, what an amazing difference. It's like, where did this camera come from? I've been looking for you all my life. I want to be able to walk back here, do the walk of focus, turn around, you know, look at the camera, step a couple of steps, turn to that wall, turn to back to you, turn to that wall, and have it work as well as the Sony A73. And suddenly, it is. So you know what I did? I bought me one. I bought the Z6. Now, I've made a recording about this, a film, a video, whatever you want to call it, about this before. Okay, but now since we're all hyped up with the Canon and the Sony and the Sony and the Canon, it's like, wait a minute, there's more choices out there. Full frame, 4K, 30p. Okay, so the Z6, the way it sits right now, doesn't do 60p. It only goes up to 4K, 30p, does 24p. It actually also does really good slow motion in 120p. So I'm going to have to make a video on that maybe later this week and show it to you. But this is the camera that I'm using right now, which is the Z5. So the major problem with this camera is that for some reason, Nikon is still in the dark ages and it has no flippy screen. So while I'm looking over here at the Olympus EM1 Mark II, I usually mark what I've got up here. See, we're kind of like faded. Maybe I'll have to make that darker to show you what camera I'm actually using. So when I'm doing my videos, you know, no matter what camera I'm talking about, you'll know what camera I'm using just by looking in the upper right-hand corner of your screen. So that's what I'm using right now. So I've got the firmware in here. I sold the Sony A73. I put it up for sale and I had a few people and, you know, I wanted it to get a good home because it's really a good camera. And there's this beautiful, wonderful couple up in the New England area. And the husband shoots weddings and the wife is shooting with him. And the wife wanted to have the same camera as her husband. So he already had an A73 in hand, in use, already ready and rolling. So they bought the camera. I shipped it out to them. They're very happy with it. There's no reason for them not to be. It's an absolutely amazing camera. But I kept my 50mm 1.4 lens because it is either an unusually sharp sample or they're all really wonderful lenses. So it's the Zeiss 50mm 1.4 lens. So I bought the Sony. I bought the Nikon at the same time that I had the Loner. So I had two Z6s here at the same time. I call them twinsies. Twinsies. Get it? Ha ha ha. Not a good joke? Well, all right, what can I tell you? So I had the twinsies in here, and I was comparing. And what was I comparing? This camera is mine, okay? I bought this camera, and I bought the FTZ adapter. Where is it? The FTZ adapter. That's what it looks like, just like that, if I can get the glare not to be on there. Okay, and that allows me to use all my really good wedding glass on this camera. So right now, I'm actually shooting with the 50mm 1.4G lens. It's not one of their best lenses, I could tell you that, but it works great. So you're watching me focus, not even with a native lens. You're watching the focus happen. I'll turn around and stop, put my hands up, then continue back down over here to the Christmas tree. I'll turn around, say hello. I can go over to the story chair. I can go over to Jingle Bells' chair, and the camera keeps focused. So then I can walk back. Don't forget, we're on an adapter now. This is not a native lens with the new Z mount, and I can stop and go, perhaps, I'm going to think it over. Okay, making a story out of this, you know. So even with the adapter, The stepping gears are much bigger, so it would have a finer focusing if I actually got the Z lens that comes with it. But they don't have a 1.4 Z lens yet. They're still coming out with that. So this camera, it was started at 2,000, 2,100, or whatever it started. And now it's slid all the way down in the $1,700 range. You get full frame. Okay, so I had that on my Sony. But I get full frame in 30p and 24p, and I didn't have that on the Sony. On the Sony, it gave me full frame camera in 24p, but if I switched over to 30p, which is what I'm working with now, I had a 1.3 or 1.2 crop, 1.2 something crop. So that would make this room look very tight. So that's how I started to get multiple cameras, because the Sony was rather tight. But now with this Nikon, there's no crop. There's no crop in 4K 30p, 4K 24p. There's no crop in 120 frames per second. In the 1080, there's no crop in 1080. So this camera does very well. No flippy screen. And if they come out with the next one without a flippy screen, I'm really going to hammer them, because I want Nikon to succeed and not make darn dumb decisions like the new Z5. I'll tell you about the Z5 in another video, and it's not going to be a very Christmas room friendly video, because I am so disgusted with that Z5. But we'll do that in another video, okay? Because I need to make something for tomorrow. Maybe I'll talk about that. Not promising. I don't know what's going to happen between today and tomorrow. So I wanted to put this on your radar screen, and then I'll switch over and talk about taking pictures with this camera for a second. This is like using one of the old D800Es, the D3Xs. The camera, the Z6, is amazing with the focus, with the clarity. It's a 24 megapixel sensor, which is perfect for events, weddings, sports, all different kinds of stuff. The focusing is excellent. Top of the line focus now. Is it the absolute best? No, I would classify the Sony focus as the best focus you can get. Then I would put the Nikon and the Canon almost side by side, with the Canon having a little bit of an edge, but not much. So I can make any of those guys falter, okay? You guys that know how to work with cameras, you can make the focusing system falter. You learn to how to do it, and then you avoid doing it. So you don't want it to actually falter. You want it to actually work properly. So this is what I wanted to bring up. The Z6 should be on your highly coveted, very short list. So if you don't feel like spending $3,900, $3,800 or $3,700 for one of the new ones, you're not missing a whole lot with this camera. I am running this right now in the Christmas room. That's my main camera. And then I've got this booger, which is a 2016 camera, which is the Olympus EM1 Mark II, which is another sleeping camera, but that's for another video. Okay, so between that camera, and then I've got the GH4, which is what I use to bring you over here to show you something close up. Okay, but I don't have nothing to show you right now. So the GH4 from Panasonic, but that one I don't have it set to automatic focus. These two main cameras, I do have them set it and forget it, as they say. Okay, I know I'm not a barbecue guy where, set it and forget it. Okay, so you just set it and then don't worry about it. That's what we're going to say for the pictures. So put the Z6, especially with the prices that they've been dropping, make sure you've got the newest firmware. And Nikon is not ashamed to put new firmware and make new cameras out of their older cameras. So that's what I wanted to bring up. The Nikon is an amazing camera. It's probably one of the best buys at $1,800 and lower, $1,700. I bought this one for $1,650. I bought this one for $1,650, and I think I had the FTZ adapter along with it. So you're watching this camera with an adapter, and it is working perfectly. Okay, all you guys that have not subscribed to me, I'm asking you to subscribe. You guys that are my subscribers, I am thankful for you, and I love you guys. So thanks for watching. Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Bye-bye.
You have just watched another Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg. Thank you for watching.